I want to fuck you in the face. I just want to grab your face and just fuck it.
That's great. That is great.
All right, so hello, people of YouTube and CTE community. Today I wanted to make a video about jets in the spring patch, in the retail version of the game. And a lot of people have been complaining about various things being broken, over-nerfed, underpowered. I just want to run through the biggest issues, and maybe some non-issues that other people have complained about, and really just nail these things down. So unfortunately, these changes were added by accident by the devs, it seems, and so I want to try and really sort out what went wrong and the changes that should not have been done. And I know that they're accidental, but they do need to be fixed in the next patch, and I want to make sure that they're enumerated so that they can be fixed, because I really don't want to have to deal with this again with the next patch. So, you know, I'm not asking jets to be overpowered. And I know a lot of you see that as the jet pilot agenda, but I think that, you know, if we look at where jets were in Battlefield, in other Battlefield games, Battlefield 3, Battlefield 2, Battlefield 4 jets are far weaker, and I want to keep them that way. I've been an infantry player in those games, and I know how awful it is to have huge bombs dropped on you in Battlefield 2 constantly, and I know how awful it is to be repeatedly killed by an unstoppable jet pilot in Battlefield 3 with no counters. So I'm not looking for overpowered jets. I just want to fix these glaring issues and get jets to where they should be in terms of balance in Battlefield 4. So I hope you'll hear me out. Most of these things are really just stuff that's blatantly broken. Then we'll get into some basic balance issues that I really do think need some fixing. Alright, so the first issue is the biggest, in my opinion, and that is the uncontrollability of jets in... Okay, that sounds dumb, but the complete uncontrollability of jets in mobility hit, mobility kills status. And I know a lot of you who haven't flown jets think that that's ridiculous, but actually, as shown first by Decor, on this subreddit, on r/Battlefield4CT, jets can sometimes throw themselves toward the ground. And, you know, not when you're moving toward the ground and then get hit, but you're aiming, say, straight, and then your jet will fly straight downward. And I will put in some clips, actually, of some normal mobility hits and kills and what they really should be and what they have been in the past, and then some weird broken ones, and you'll also see some weird teleporting going on, and it's very strange because I wasn't aware of any initiative in the CTE to change mobility hits in any way. Now the only thing I've heard in the community or seen it read in the community is to remove mobility hits for various vehicles or altogether. So it's kind of crazy that they're trying to change them in any way that wouldn't be a large nerf to mobility hits or removal. I personally don't really have an issue with mobility hits in the way they were before, but now they're ridiculous, and I'm sure it's an error because of the way the teleporting is going on and the strange mechanics. And it is kind of hard to see what is going on when you're not flying the jet, but you'll, you know, it won't be a user error. You'll seem to just fly straight toward the ground for some reason. So that's the first major issue. The second one is actually a bug that affects all vehicles, and it's quite annoying. I'm going to just show a quick clip here. I haven't bothered to save any others. Basically, if you miss the spawn on a vehicle when it first spawns, you'll be spawned in the base, in the main base, which is usually a completely useless and wasted spawn. Often, this is at the start of a round when all of your vehicles are being taken, so you'll be left in the main base without a vehicle. You'll have to redeploy. The way this should work, obviously, is that you should not be able to... your spawn should just not happen if you fail to spawn in the vehicle. So, I'm sad about this one, to a certain extent, because it means, in many cases, it means the end of easy dogfights. But the end of 313 is nigh, and I think, though many non-jet pilots have clamored for this one, I think that, you know, whatever, they have reasonable arguments that dogfights should not be based on a random number. That's, you know, I'm not sure how it's going to work out logistically, but it really, I suppose the old mechanic doesn't make logical sense. In terms of actual gameplay, for skilled pilots, it may suck. Skilled pilots may be locked in extensively long dogfights with very new pilots, which is just a waste of time for everybody. That's my biggest fear, is just spending all my time dogfighting when I should be helping my team. But that's kind of beside the point. It's already been decided by the CTE that 313 is going out the window. Obviously, the issue right now in the retail game is that the stealth jets do not have this mechanic, this new mechanic, and the attack jets do. Really quick, I just want to say that I think that the attack jet should have a faster turning radius, and the average turn speed should be about where it used to be when there was the 313 mechanic, and then. Same with the stealth jet. When it's 313 gets removed, its average turn speed should be faster than it would be if you just removed the 313 thing. It just feels like I'm flying a hunk of big bricks around, and I think that if you increase the maneuverability of both jets, I think that would be definitely very reasonable. As long as the stealth jet is more maneuverable and has a tighter radius than the attack jet, I really don't think it really matters very much. I also would like to see, with the removal of 313, maybe a slightly smaller gap between the turn radiuses of the two jets, because you can't just win dogfights by knowing 313 and the attack jet anymore. I think that it would be a good idea to bring them slightly closer, but don't get me wrong, the stealth jet should win in dogfights against the attack jet. Alright, the next thing that's a problem is very prevalent when you're flying jets, but isn't as apparent when you're doing this test here. So, with the transport heli, it's still very, very clear. So, it takes an entire belt with belt feeder with the attack jet to destroy a transport heli now. Keep in mind that this whole belt that it takes is probably about two tanks. That's just an estimate, though. Maybe even three, honestly. Two and a half. And generally, regardless of how much a whole belt does to a transport chopper, I'm generally doing 25, 30, 20 damage per strafe on transport helis. We're talking, you know, big, meaty strafes. That's a little ridiculous, if you ask me. then for the stealth jet, the 30s did 75 damage with the hull belt. The 25s did 66 damage in one belt, and the 20s destroyed the transport heli with a full belt, and none of those were with belt feeder. And then the attack jet without belt feeder did 75 damage. Now, jets used to be really powerful against transport helis, especially. Attack jets were exceptionally powerful against transport helis. Stealth jets were okay. I honestly think that stealth jets should be rebuffed to where they were before versus transport helis. I think they were fine. And attack jets should probably see a significant buff. Honestly, I haven't used 20 millimeters very much against transport helis, but the other two, especially I've been using 25s, are very weak, just like the attack jets. And honestly, what I want to see is a 200% buff to the attack jet cannons versus transport helis, which I want to result in about a 2-strafe kill. And so I think that a one strafe kill should be virtually impossible. You know, maybe 75 if you jam on the brakes, but then you should be punished by, obviously, the miniguns on the transport helis. Really, the key here is that the transport heli needs to be able to do its job of transporting units from A to B without getting blown up, like on Parasol Storm. If the transport chopper can't make it out of from the carrier to the land objectives, then that's no fun at all. So I think that there needs to be some kind of a midway point that we can reach. Now, more importantly, because transport helis are somewhat irrelevant, actually, what really matters are the other two helicopters, which are the scout helicopter and the attack helicopter. And so we've all seen the attack helicopter grow into a real man recently. I think that even though it is buffed, it is still not anything like what it has been in Battlefield 3 or Battlefield 4, Battlefield 2 or Battlefield 3. And I think that it does need significantly more hit points than the scout heli because it's so much bigger and easier to hit, especially when we're considering jets. So the 20mm cannons on the stealth jets are supposed to be for air dominance. So I really think that the 20mm cannons on the stealth jets should be really destroying helicopters. And I don't mean like anything ridiculous, but they should be definitely at least where they were before the patch or better. They should not be anything less than that. Otherwise, there would be no point in using 20mm cannons. The other cannons, I think, should see probably 133% at the very least. Probably 150% to 200 versus scout helis. You know, 175, 166% buff, somewhere in there. Wherever it seems like jets aren't single strafing helicopters, but also helicopters can't just take strafe after strafe, especially scout helicopters with reps. I do really want to see a large discrepancy between the attack helicopter and the scout helicopter. The scout helicopter is smaller and should have less hit points, and it's also just harder to hit. So if you give it the same number of hit points, it's almost as if it has twice as many hit points. And when I said that jets shouldn't be able to single strafe helis, I meant that it shouldn't be a regular thing. However, if the helicopter is flying away from you, then that, you know, a single strafe makes sense. Or if they're flying still, or just hovering, you know, they're an easy target and you can get a ton of hits into them. I don't see why, especially with the 20 millimeters on the stealth jet, I don't see why that they shouldn't be single strafe kills. Alright, so now I want to talk about the attack jet metagame a little bit, and it's kind of hard for me to talk about this in a way that makes sense and also sounds smart. So because I really just play based on experience. I know this format's weird too. This is MS Paint. I'm gonna just kind of describe what happened on a round, on a pub, on Lanking Dam. This is Lanking Dam. So this is me. This is RU, right? Yeah, the RU. And this is the enemy. This is China, over here. So I was in the Frogfoot. I was in the attack jet. And so pretty quickly, my team pushed up, and I achieved air dominance over this part of the map. So that's pretty standard. So there was a pesky A, probably, I think he was right about here. And after the first attack jet spawned, there was another attack jet. So, obviously there was. So, here I am. I'm flying my fancy attack jet. And I know this seems childish here, but bear with me. So, here I am. And I can, in the attack jet, I can hang out around here because there's this big dam. So I can just hide behind the dam and not get hit by anything. So, but obviously that keeps me in a place where I can't do anything. So a lot of people complain about the invulnerability of jets. Keep in mind that while jets are invulnerable, they are also completely ineffective. And in some cases that's not entirely true. You know, you can get very high up and drop JDAMs, but for the most part you are largely ineffective at any kind of place where you're invulnerable. So here I am, back here mostly. Well, that is once the AA starts attacking me. So the AA's range is very far, and I've gotten used to this, so I'm not going to really complain about it. So he can really shoot active radars accurately within this kind of a range. And with the current state of mobility hits, that is a huge problem. So I generally have to pop ECM and completely avoid the locks. Luckily, there is kind of a small gap where I can usually ward off active radars with ECM. So the problem with this is very standard. This is what always has happened. The problem with the new time to kill in jets is a very large one, because there's also, guess what, a base AA here, which shoots at you automatically if you're spotted. And of course, me being the fancy big attack jet, everyone wants to spot me all the time, so I'm pretty much always spotted. Now, this is fine, I'm used to this, I can kill the AA until Mr. Other Attack Jet comes along. You know, this is also kind of standard, because this happens with stealth jets, who are not absolutely horrible. They used to do this to me sometimes, but this is amplified to a horrible level with new time to kill. So what happened over and over was this guy would just charge me, and he would get probably 50 into me because I was in the Frogfoot, which is a large jet, pretty easy to open. So I was getting lit, and he would just charge me, and so I would dogfight him over behind the dam. I would dogfight him, and each time, this happened about 3 times, and so for the beginning of the round I had 0 kills for probably 5 minutes. And so we dogfighted back here, and then he would always lose the dogfight, and then he would fly, guess where? He would fly right back here, and because after he lost the dogfight, I couldn't get very much damage into him because of the new time to kill. He was basically invulnerable. Whenever he would lose a dogfight, he would just go straight back here, where I could do absolutely nothing. Now, if the AA didn't exist, I would just follow him to his spawn and kill him. But I can't, because there's an AA. Now, logically, I would want to kill the AA because of this. But because there's a jet, if I push into the spawn to kill the AA, then the jet will kill me, and also possibly the base AA. So here I am. This is a situation which is exceptionally aggravating. And let me try and anticipate some of the counter-arguments here. So one counter-argument is that I should call for help with my from my stealth jet friend. So in pubs, generally, they're not used effectively. But, you know, so what I could have done differently is I could have just relinquished the airspace control, which I generally never do. That generally does not work. So he would have had all of this area, and I would have been stuck back here. Now, the main reason why I don't want to do this is because I already have this cover back here. So I'm actually giving that up when I give away that airspace. So that's kind of pointless because I want to stick back here mostly. Instead, I'm kind of stuck over here where there actually isn't very much cover. And the base, the AA can often still hit you when you're over here. Now, if that had happened, I would have been doing basically what he was doing. And that creates exactly the same situation, except I would probably win the dogfight, but then he would just fly back to his base. So what I'm getting at here is that attack jets cannot really fight each other anymore, because all these dogfights just end in attack jets running to their base. Of course, I have, you know, successfully dogfought other attack jets, but generally the people that I was dogfighting either weren't cowards and they didn't just run away, or they just didn't really know what they were doing. So I imagine, so basically what I'm saying is that the attack jet metagame is broken right now because of the low time to kill versus other jets. There's really no skill involved. Basically all you have to do is bait the other guy into getting himself killed, and that's really, it's just silly. This, you know, I don't want to be hiding behind a dam. I want to be destroying tanks. I want to have this air control because I'm the better jet pilot here. I beat him in every single dogfight. I want to be able to control this part of the map and destroy tanks for my teammates. That's my job as the attack jet. And I can't do that if every single time I try to strafe somebody in this area, this is where all the tanks are, I get killed by this guy who's just retreating back to his base whenever I don't try to engage him, or whenever I do engage him. So please increase the time to kill from jet to jet, and feel free to do it from stealth jet to attack jet as well. I honestly do not care. It just needs to be to a level where I can kill a retreating jet. Now, after that heated discussion, just really quick, I want to say that I don't think attack jets are underpowered at all versus armored units, including the AA. I think that their time to kill is perfect right now where it is. It's pretty difficult to get a single strafe kill on a tank unless you use JDAMs, which I think is fine. I think that tanks are very killable. I think that anybody, and I have seen people saying that the attack jet is now being drawn away from its anti-armor role, and I disagree. So I just like to say that here. Also, the attack jet is very powerful versus infantry, and honestly, it could be nerfed in that department, or just buff it so that one hit kills infantry, including splash damage. That would be also really awesome. The very last balance problem is not a new one. But it is, as I kind of hinted at in the discussion about the attack jet time to kill on Lanking Dam, the AA is just too powerful as something that just sits in the main base. First of all, it is assisted by the base AA. In terms of food chain, it's also invulnerable to tanks, which should be the counter to AAs. And then also, it has a very, very long range, and it is actually arguably most effective in the base because of its virtual invulnerability. The best way to kill an AA when it is in the main base is to just drop a JDAM on it when it's not expecting it. And then once it has a JDAM in it, it's pretty much butter. So you just strafe it one more time and it dies 90% of the time, every time. Unfortunately, against a skilled player, that doesn't work because the JDAMs can be dodged fairly easily, especially from a distance from which it would need to be sneaky. And you can't really sneak up on skilled players as well as you can noobs. And that isn't even mentioning maps like Dawnbreaker, where I ran into a guy who would just sit in the main base with the AA, and there aren't any JDAMs on that map, so... And eventually I got him with a quad bike. But if he's deep enough in the base, you're not going to be able to quad bike him. Bottom line is that AAs in the base are too effective. And some people have proposed that the best way to limit the AA's abilities in the main spawn is to create a timer or kills don't count or something like that. And I think that that's very, you know, battlefield, to be honest with you. In a game like Battlefield 2, there weren't even any home bases that were places you couldn't go. You could on Gulf of Oman, it was perfectly regular for the Middle Eastern Coalition to bring a transport helicopter to the carrier and get a squad of snipers to just snipe all the U.S. guys out of the helicopters as they got in. And I don't think that's a place we want to regress to, but the bases are a place where you should be able to be, especially in a situation where your team is being base raped or trapped in your own base. And so I think the best way to mitigate the effectiveness of the AA is to simply limit its range. And I think the best way to do that is to just nerf the velocity on the activator missiles. I think that's really all you need to do. And as I've been saying, as everyone's been saying, take off the mobility hits for the activator missiles, and all of the activator complaining will go away, I promise. And if it doesn't, I will personally tell them to shut up, because they should be thankful. Now, if this was done, I don't think we would see... I think we would still see... Okay, I'm going to be honest. I think we would still see plenty of players sitting in the AA in their base. However, like it should be in Battlefield, they should pay for their low risk with a low reward. And right now, that's simply not the case. So basically, what I'm asking for is some kind of a nerf to the AA, because with the removal of the double drop for JDAMs, and also decreased armor effectiveness for the stealth jet, you can't drop two LGMs at once. I think we really need to focus on a way to stop the AA from just camping in the base, because right now, it's more effective than ever. Alright, that's everything. Honestly, if those things were changed and fixed, I think that we would have a solid game, a balanced game. I don't think Jets would be too powerful, but I also don't think that they would be so weak and so broken that no one would want to fly them anymore. And honestly, I hope that you guys can respect the fact that Jets need to be a high-skill vehicle. And Jets need to be an effective vehicle on the battlefield, and not just something that, you know, anybody can hop into and crash into a helicopter and jump out and get an objective. Like, that should not be what Jets are useful for. Because, honestly, that's pretty effective right now. So let's discuss this with the acknowledgement that these changes were a mistake on DICE's part. They were not meant to be added, and it should not be considered a legitimate change in the first place. And so changes from now like a 200% buff are not unreasonable like they would be in any other circumstance. I think that we need to really consider the roles and the risk-reward involved with different vehicles and really think about what makes players want to fly jets. Right now, there's not much going for jets. We need to change that. Thank you.